Raiders play at the Steelers at 1 Eastern on Sunday. Now, listen up. Early games are tough for Oakland, who's lost 6 of their last 18 games played on Sundays at 1 Eastern. They play a Steelers team who will be without Le'Veon Bell. In 2 games without Bell this season, D'Angelo Williams ran for 204 yards. Who wins?
I'm rolling with the Steelers. Aww. Okay, I'm rolling with the Steelers. I mean, listen. I will openly confess that the Oakland Raiders have surprised me. I mean, I know Derek Carr can play. I believe Amari Cooper's a stud. Khalil Mack speaks for itself. Justin Tuck's leadership. I didn't expect Charles Woodson to have the kind of year that he's having. He's been absolutely sensational. Proud of you, bro. Keep it up. But let me say this. As depressed as I am at another injury to Le'Veon Bell, incurred and initiated by the Cincinnati Bengals, okay? D'Angelo Williams is not too shabby.
Oh, he's good.
This is a starting running back in almost any other system. With the Steelers, he's a backup. He's averaging the same amount of yards per carry as Le'Veon Bell was at 4.9. I'm thinking about Ben Roethlisberger. Got a week, an extra week after working off the rust last week in the loss to the Cincinnati Bengals. Okay? So I expect things to be a little bit different this year. Is Oakland a good team? Yes. I don't think they're better than the Cincinnati Bengals. So we take that into account. Then you still got Antonio Brown. You still got Marcus Wheaton. You still have Martavis Bryant. You still have Heath Miller. You still have all of these requisite weapons. And dare I say, the Steelers' defense deserves a little bit of love compared to what they've usually been. It's a 6th-ranked defense in the NFL.
Okay.
A 6th-ranked defense in the NFL. 8 against the run, of course, even though they're 26th against the pass. I'm not happy about that. That worries me, especially when you take into account Amari Cooper. But nevertheless, and I look at Murray for Oakland, very impressive. I got all of that. But they're in Pittsburgh. They had to go from the West Coast to the East Coast. It's a 1 o'clock game, which is 10 in the morning for them. There's a whole bunch of little issues, little nuggets of issues working against them. And on top of it all, I don't think Ben Roethlisberger is going to look that bad 2 weeks in a row. Am I concerned about him? Sure I am. Because obviously when you get hit the way that he got hit against St. Louis, that's problematic because even though you might be healthy with that brace on, you're still dancing in the pocket. I even expect the Steelers to make an improvement special teams-wise, excuse me. Dre Archer got cut. Wasn't producer for you. You got it, Jacoby Jones.
Oh, that was hysterical.
The same dude that Tomlin got in trouble for standing near the sideline a few years back. So they didn't trip him.
He did not trip.
Watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. Mike Tomlin would never do such a thing.
Yes,
the point that I'm trying to make
to you. Anything to win.
Well, not anything. He ain't Bill Belichick, but let's not go there.
They did find him. They did find him.
They find him. So what? We get over it. Nobody's perfect in life. The point is, that's right. Nobody's perfect in life.
Okay.
The point is, the Steelers have a lot going for them in this game. Had it been in Oakland, I would have been considerably more worried. I know that Oakland is much improved. I respect them. And not only that, they're on a come up to the point where you're the Steelers. You're clearly not going to win the AFC North. These games are pivotal because I believe the wild card spots in the AFC are being fought between Oakland, Pittsburgh, and the New York Jets with Miami and Buffalo still in the mix. Steelers have to win this game. This is a very important game. I think they close the deal. They get it done. Steelers, 31. Oakland, 24.
Mm. And you grew up a fan of the
Steelers.
Pittsburgh Steelers. Yes. Thank you very much.
Yes. I bring that up until when you talk about the Cowboys. Do I bring that up all the time?
You're welcome to. I love the Dallas Cowboys, and I have since I was like 8 years old,
right,
whenever they started, 1960.
You actually root for things to happen just to facilitate your team.
That's true. I do. Pathetic. I admit it. Now, speaking of picking with heart over head, I am also going to pick with my heart on this game because I have
slowly fallen
in love with the Oakland Raiders.
You have.
I love their rebirth because I covered the last Raiders team when I was out in the Bay Area. They got to the Super Bowl and then got humiliated, obviously, by John Gruden's team.
Very bad.
But at least...
When the dude went to Mexico, right?
The night before the dude went to Mexico.
The night before the Super Bowl.
Unfortunately. Yeah, I was in San Diego, and he went down the... Yeah, okay. So we weren't good enough.
Yes, but, yes.
Okay. So I'm picking with my heart here, but I do think the Raiders at 4-3 have a real shot at beating your Steelers.
I agree.
With Ben still a little tentative on his knee. He's still not sure of himself. And listen, this Khalil Mack can bring the thunder off the edge.
He's special.
He will cause some problems.
He's special.
For, for Mr. Roethlisberger. Mm-hmm. Okay, so remember when I picked the Raiders to beat Denver in the black hole? And that I was way out on the limb with that one. Remember what happened? The Raiders are driving for the winning football. 6:53 left in the game. It's 3rd and 5 at the Denver 31. They're almost in range. They're almost in range for Sebastian Janikowski to win the game. And young Derek Carr throws a pick six to Chris Harris. He takes it 74 yards the other way. And that's how they lost that game. A narrow loss to a really good Denver team. And the other tough loss was against my guy Jay Cutler in Chicago, in which Derek Carr made the play to win the game with 2 minutes left, and then Jay Cutler goes boom, boom, boom down the field, and a last-second buzzer-beating field goal wins the game. So, mm-hmm. So those are the two tough losses they've had. And this time, I'm going to say that this is one team that has a meant-to-be feel to it, and your team this year does not have a meant-to-be. It's like meant not to be.
That's fair. That's fair. If you're using that, I can't argue with that, because that definitely has a feel where the Oakland Raiders have paid their, mm-hmm. you know, their dues, yeah. and as a result, their time has arrived. I just think with the multitude of weapons that the Steelers have, particularly if Ben Roethlisberger, obviously he can't be what he was last week. He can't be that ailing quarterback that comes to the rescue, because Landry Jones was a one-hit wonder after Michael Vick went down a couple of weeks ago against Arizona. It can happen. Mm-hmm. Okay, so Ben Roethlisberger has to be healthy, and I know that there are some things that have to work in the Steelers' way. But at the same time, I just think that the game being in Pittsburgh goes a long way. Yep. A lot of damage we've seen from the Oakland Raiders, even though, in fairness to them, they lost to two undefeated teams, and they lost on a late rally to Jay Cutler and the Chicago Bears. Okay. But there's no denying that the Raiders look impressive. Amari Cooper mm-hmm. is special. He's already got nearly 600 receiving yards, and it's just 7 games into the season. I want to take a moment to give some love to Jack Del Rio, the former defensive coordinator in Denver, who's now the head coach for the Oakland Raiders. I think he's doing a good job. And I got to tell you something as well. I'm going to give the offensive line coach, Mike Tice, so a little bit of love here. They're protecting. Derek Carr's only been sacked 8 times. You got a running game. This is a guy that's going largely unnoticed. Obviously, the line of scrimmage is where all the damage gets done. So I see what Oakland's doing, and they deserve a lot of credit. But I think the multitude of weapons the Steelers have at their disposal, combined with being in Pittsburgh, goes a long way. Am I worried? Sure I am. Derek Carr's only thrown 3 interceptions on the season. Mm-hmm. Got 15 touchdowns. He's completing 65% of his passes. This brother can play.
Really impressive. He's also thrown touchdown passes to 8 different receivers.
That's right.
And one of those is the Todd Gurley of rookie receivers, Amari Cooper, right?
Yes.
Okay, so I got that going for me.
Yeah, you do.
Here's why
you
I'm do. Scared.
And the Steelers don't have the greatest secondary either.
Okay.
Speaking of secondaries.
Yes.
Even though my Raiders have held opponents under 100 yards rushing for 5 straight games, the reason they've done that is because their pass defense ranks 31st.
That's right.
So Ben should have a pretty good day, But I'm still going to go Raiders 27-23.
Steelers will have to pass, and that's the interesting part. If Le'Veon Bell were healthy, they might be running the football more against the number 2 rushing attack.
Maybe.
Defensively in the NFL in Oakland. Whereas with Le'Veon out, you're not going to rely on D'Angelo as much. Mm. And as a result, you're going to throw the football more.
Another great one.
Yeah.
So we've got a good slate this weekend. Pittsburgh's favored by 4.5. And this one. Will Leonard Fournette stiff-arm the competition this weekend and lock up the Heisman race against Bama? We'll get into that on the other side. This is First Take.